And I told him, the shop smells like a privy. I will treat it as such.
Captain, reporting with the new prisoner.
Signed by the Emperor.
Shut your mouth. It's like we've caught quite a fish today. Political insurrection against the Empire. You.
Dirty old beggar.
Sir, he's of the way.
Martinian, is it?
Yes, sir.
What way? Say what you mean, guardsman.
He's a follower of the one they call Jesus the Christ.
Jesus the Christ? A religious fanatic. Is that all we get here these days? Name. What is his name?
Simon Peter of Galilee.
They call him the fisherman. He knew Jesus.
Enough! Take him to the box. Let him convert the rats.
Thank you for this chance to suffer for you. Thy will be done. Thy will be done. Is it you, Lord? Ask your God to save us. Are you afraid he'll deny you? Jesus says, I will neither leave you nor forsake you. There's no reward waiting for you in the kingdom. My master can free you from this suffering and provide great riches. All you need do is deny him, as you did before.
That was long ago.
I have been forgiven. Do not speak to me about your temporary earthly riches. I now have everlasting riches beyond anything that you can provide.
Have you? Has your father told you that? My master told me a secret. Perhaps he will tell you too when you meet him.
That I shall die in 3 days? Begone, demon!
3 days, Simon Peter. 3 days and your life.
In the name of Jesus,
I cast you!
Something in the way you called my name. An ordinary fisherman. You called me friend and took me in. How everything had changed. It was then I knew I'd never be the same. Love came and rescued me. I gave up my everything to follow. Now I know all that I was before. It won't matter anymore, for I am a new man. 'Cause I have seen my Savior face to face.
I tell you, Peter, before the rooster crows today, you will disown me. 3 times.
I recall standing in the courtyard by the fire. Words still ringing in my head. 3 times before the break of morn, you would be denied. And yet I saw no judgment in your eyes. Love came and died for me. I gave up my everything to follow. Now I know all that I was before is dead and it lives no more, for I am a new man, 'cause I have seen my Savior face to face. The dark night,
shall I send? Who will go for us? The question echoed in the Old Testament is being fulfilled.
You are Simon, son of John. You will be called Peter.
Peter, you are the rock, and on you I will build my church. The forces of the underworld shall not prevail against it. He was like a grain of sand on the seashore of Galilee, vulnerable to be tossed by the least of the waves of the sea. Now he has been formed into a solid rock, a rock to become the cornerstone for building up. Simon is transformed to Peter. Years, decades, centuries. Darkness and sovereignties rose against it, but were shattered, and the rock remained firm. Who shall I send? Who is going on our behalf? Those who heard and gave an ear came out of their dwellings ready to go. 265 were called and anointed to hold the staff of the Great Shepherd. On March 13, 2013, the chimney of the Sistine Chapel emitted the white smoke, and the bells of the St. Peter's Basilica joyously chimed, announcing the 266th successor to the Holy See. When Cardinal Jorge Mario Bergoglio set out from Argentina, the plan was to participate in the conclave and return. But the will of God was different. The keys of St. Peter entrusted to the cardinal from Latin America.
Annuncio vobis Gaudium Magnum. Habemus Papam. Eminentissimum ac reverendissimum Dominum, Dominum Georgium Marium, Sancte Romanae Ecclesiae Cardinalem Bergoglium.
Facciamo in silenzio questa preghiera di voi su di me.
Bowing down in front of the crowd of St. Peter's Square, resting their prayers, he was submitting to the will of God. The shepherd, the world longing for, the supreme of the humble, the prophet of mercy. Prepare to stand for the human values. The old norms were uprooted. He speaks of a new spirituality, which he always spoke. The streets of Buenos Aires bear witness to it. Pope Francis is becoming epitome of peace and tolerance. United Arab Emirates holding the flag of peace and tolerance in front of the entire world. UAE always dreams of progress and prosperity and inspires others to dream of progress and prosperity. That's why UAE is dear to all the citizens as well as all the residents here, and its rulers become adorable for all. The Vatican and United Arab Emirates think alike. The borders of religion are narrowed down when they speak of fraternity. A new chapter is going to open in the history. The Roman pontiff set his foot for the first time in the soil of Arabian Peninsula. The will of the Prince of Peace. The dream of the history. UAE's search and efforts for tolerance. Pope Francis was invited. Let's prepare to welcome the Great Shepherd. Let's witness the historical moments.